Did you know that the U.S. currently holds 2.3 million prisoners, which is roughly a quarter of the world's prison population? Considering that only 5% of the world's population inhabits the U.S., this is a big number. You might be wondering, how does our country house all those inmates? While state-run prisons are where most of the inmates are being held, there is another method that is being used. This method is private prisons, or prisons for profit. Unlike state-run prisons, private prisons are run on the basis of making profits off their inmates. Keep in mind that prisons are a public service, and any time you try to take a public service, privatize it, and make money off it, then corruption is ended. There are three main arguments for private prisons. The first is that they save taxpayers money because they are not government-run facilities and therefore do not use taxpayer money. The second is that they can be run just efficiently, if not more efficiently, than state-run prisons. The third argument is that they provide the surrounding community with secure and well-paying jobs. The fact is that all three of these arguments are false. First, let's address the taxpayer argument. In a state-run prison, the average living cost for one inmate is about $20,000 per year. Multiply that by 2.3 million incarcerated in our country today, you get an annual cost of about $46 billion per year. While the private sector is subject to only a part of this debt, it does make you wonder how it's possible for them to make money off their inmates when they have to spend $20,000 a year on each of them. And as far as saving taxpayers' money goes, there's little or no difference. Private prisons have to get paid by someone, and in most cases, the state pays for them. State governments make contracts to fund private prisons, and the government gets all of its money from taxpayers. So the argument that taxpayers are saving money is obviously false.
That video showed you about that.
Called the Corrections Corporation of America.
The notion that a corporation making a profit off this practice is more important to us than public safety or the human rights of prisoners is outrageous.
Almost 7% of America's inmates are now housed in private prisons. It's much more here in Colorado, where almost one in four inmates is in a private facility. Colorado's inmate population has exploded. It's six times larger than it was in 1980. As a result, the state forks over almost $95 million a year in taxpayer money to corporate jailers to house its excess prisoners.
In light of these financial shortcomings, it is hard to see how private prisons can support their claims of being more efficient than state prisons and still make money. In fact, the track record of private prisons has proven that their efficiency is not nearly as good as that of state prisons. A good example of that is the Youngstown, Ohio prison scandal. A private prison was constructed in Youngstown, Ohio, out of an old motel. Besides the fact that they used a motel for the prison, there were many other problems. The prison was constructed too quickly, which resulted in some serious security issues. The prison was also understaffed, and the staff that was there was not properly trained in how to handle inmates. The prison was also overpopulated and not properly stocked with the basic living essentials, such as toiletries or medication for ill inmates. As a result, there were 44 riots, 6 escapes, and 2 deaths in the first year. Looking at all these shortcomings, it's hard to see how a prison can bring secure and well-paying jobs to its communities. Typically, having a job in prison is a dangerous one, but having a job in a private prison is much more dangerous than that of a state prison. While understaffing is a major problem in most prisons, it is of extreme concern in private prisons. Private prisons are typically far more understaffed than state prisons, and their staff is usually not well-trained. But private prisons do not require the amount of training that state prisons do, which helps them save money. The lack of training of the staff results in the abuse of prisoners and a general inability to control the inmates, which makes for unsafe prisons. Also, prisoners have been known to abuse the guards too, and the guards abuse towards the prisoners. And since the staff is so outnumbered, there is not much they can do for that themselves. The annual salary for most private prison guards is roughly $20,000 a year, which is about $390 a week. This is not a very well-paying job, especially for a time as contingent. You can see that logically, the arguments for the use of private prisons are false, based on the way our prison system works and the history of private prisons proves it. It also shows that if someone tries to privatize a public service, then corners will be cut somewhere. So what can we do about them? Well, the big problem is that there isn't much we can do about them, because they're private prisons. Because they're private businesses, they aren't subject to the same scrutiny as state facilities. Also, since they're privately operated, they can be built anywhere as long as the companies buy the land. For the most part, it is an issue that goes unnoticed. And as long as it goes unnoticed, nothing will be done about it. So the best thing we can do is learn about it and bring it up with the officials we elect into office to make sure that they feel the same way about the issue as we do. So really, it is up to us to bring it into the spotlight.